Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. flies to Indonesia on his first state visit as the country's leader. During the three-day trip, Marcos is expected to meet with Indonesian President Joko Widodo, with whom he will be witnessing the signing of agreements on the areas of defense and culture. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says a comprehensive plan of action charting the two countries' bilateral priorities in the next 5 years will also be signed. Hundreds of Filipinos gathered at a hotel in Jakarta to welcome Marcos on Sunday.
Your good standing in Indonesian society has contributed to sustaining trade, tourism, people-to-people links between our countries. Your success here makes us all back home very, very, very proud. Every time we hear news of yet another success by our OFWs, we are always saying thank you for the glory you bring to our country, for the good name that you burnish and polish of our country abroad while you are abroad. Iba talaga ang galing ng Pinoy saan man sa mundo.
Not included in the president's agenda, visiting Filipino death row convict Mary Jane Veloso. The palace says that is a matter best left to the Foreign Affairs Department.
We can't say officially. It's always an issue. Perhaps it will be broached by both parties, by one or both parties. We'll have to see. I understand since it's a pending issue, it may be inescapable, but we will announce if it is taken up.
Marcos will stay in Indonesia until Tuesday and then travel to Singapore through Wednesday.
President Marcos may not be expected to visit Mary Jane Veloso, but her family hopes Marcos can bring up her case when he meets with Indonesian leader Joko Widodo. Veloso has been detained in Indonesia for 12 years after being convicted on drug trafficking charges. Veloso's family claims she was framed by illegal recruiters. She has been sentenced to death but was granted a reprieve in 2015 to become a witness against illegal recruiters in the Philippines. Her family is hoping Veloso can be released soon through the help of the president.
Talagang humihingi ng tulong sa ating mahal na Panginoon. Lalong-lalo na kay pangalawa si ating mahal na Pangulo na pumunta siya sa Indonesia na ipinalangin ko talaga na sana mabanggit niya yung clemency para makalaya na yung anak ko. Sana mapag-usapan nila ni Widodo. Ang pag-asa na lang po namin ang ating mahal na Pangulo.
President Marcos hoping to bring home investments and sign agreements that will advance the economy during his first foreign trips. That's why, aside from Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, he also brought with him his economic team, including Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno and Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual. In his departure speech, the president said he also wants to reaffirm ties with fellow archipelagic nations.
I expect that we will be coming back with a harvest of business deals to be signed in my state visits that will further strengthen our economic ties with both Indonesia and Singapore. This is to once again put the Philippines in a position where we have strong alliances and strong partnerships which are necessary for us to come out of the post-pandemic economy.
The president hopes his trips will benefit the agriculture and energy sectors and address the issues of food supply and high prices.
Vice President Sara Duterte has been designated as officer in charge while President Marcos travels to Indonesia and Singapore. The vice president is given the task of attending to the day-to-day operations of the office of the president. She is also authorized to act on behalf of Marcos, except on matters when the Constitution requires the president to act in person. All departments, agencies, and instrumentalities of the government are instructed to assist Duterte in performing their functions. Meanwhile, Malacanang confirmed yesterday that former Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Locsin Jr. has been appointed as the new Philippine ambassador to the United Kingdom. His jurisdiction includes Ireland, the Isle of Man, and the Bailiwick of Jersey and Guernsey.